what was going on, especially in the first quarter on D?
To respond. I didn't know. Coming from that break, I had to readjust and try to get something on the defensive end first. I think that's been the point of emphasis every time that we come into practice and every time we come into game. So for me to come into this game and have a defensive mindset was my main focus.
Yeah, you ended up having an efficient scoring night too, but when other guys are getting going offensively, does that sometimes let you, you know, have a little more emphasis on the defensive end, a little more energy there?
Absolutely. I think our defense opens up our offense, but for me to have those guys be confident in what they're doing, be aggressive when I'm open, and them guys, those guys being aggressive when they're open, it opens our scoring, and just brings more confidence to the team.
You know, you said you aspire to eventually being one of those guys, you know, two-way star at that top level. Does it take a different level of energy you're noticing to really do it on both ends night to night? Is that kind of one of those difference makers those guys have?
Absolutely. I took 9 shots tonight. And it takes a lot of energy to do it on both ends, to be locked in on the defensive end and guard the best player in and try to be the man on the offensive end. So as many times as I do it and try to guard the best player on the floor and just have the mentality to do that every single night, then I think I have a better chance of being that two-way player.
9 straight home wins. How do you take this on the road for this 4-game trip?
Just have the same main focus. The same focus of on the defensive end, to be confident on the offensive end, and continue this chemistry that we've been having.
What did Julius tell you to do for making that 3-pointer?
I won't take anything now. I think I show him a lot of love on that block a little bit, so he returned the favor.
What's it been like? Did you just see him have these types of nights, especially tonight? What was going for him?
Well, good thing about Julius is when he's really big in the paint, I don't think no one can stop him. I think when he attacks, and he's the aggressor for our team, and I don't think he can be stopped down low.
What's it like being on the floor when Lonzo and Isaiah are playing together?
It's a different dynamic. I think you have a passing guard in Lonzo, and you have dominant scorer in Isaiah, and I think you can spread the floor a lot. And Isaiah, when he attacks, he attracts a lot of people in the paint, and he has guys to kick it out to who can knock down shots, and other guys on the floor who can get to the basket. So it's just a lot of attraction to the defense.
Do you feel your time as a point guard coming to an end with
No, if we keep winning games, I don't think I'll be out of that position. But whatever happens, I'll be fine with it. I'll try to readjust to it and try to be as effective as I can be.